Happy Thumbs Gaming. Week show.
Hey everybody, it's Brian again with Happy Thumbs Gaming. Today we're checking out Lockboxes 2 of 2 for North Point for Sleeping Dogs. Essentially, there are 40 total lockboxes in the North Point area, and it was just simply too much to put in one video, or so we thought. So we split them up in half. And the first 20 can be found on the other video, and we are continuing right where we left off. So we're going to go ahead and follow our way on the map here and go destroy these guys. Luckily, we brought our cleaver from the last one and didn't make it very long. But Patrick Swayze'd those guys at Roadhouse. And yeah, buddy. So now we're going to move on over here and go ahead and grab 21 of 40. All right, making some progress. 10K, we'll take it. Alright, so now here we are in front of the police station. If you are unfamiliar where the North Point Police Station is, it is right there. See? Look, right there. There's tons of police on the street, so watch out for those dudes. Because, truth be told, I pulled in here to get this, and as I did, I accidentally ran over a cop, and I had to go run from the cops and break that before I could actually come and display this for you guys. So, be careful with the cops, especially right at the front entrance. They like to stand in your way, presenting an extra problem, so... Bleak a shout, two down. All right, so a lot of these are going to be guarded by enemies, and although the enemies will always be there, even if you smash on them and you drive across the map and you return, they will return. But in this particular case, we have not got the lockbox yet, so we're going to go and destroy these guys. We found that it's best to try to take out large groups with cars, not only for time constraints, but also because it's easier. You just drive over everybody. Look how easy that was. Yay. One nice pass. And you see me throw on the lights. Boop, 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 boop. That's right. Tell us crooked cops. Roll. Alright, so we went ahead and we grabbed that bad boy. Now we're moving on to number 24. Alright. So we're just right across the way. Some more enemies. And essentially we're going to use this same car that's already beat up. We don't do so well on our... taking out dudes at the car this time, so we hop out and actually bust some face. Boom! Just one quick kick to the chest is all it took. We'll go ahead and grab number 25. Put it in our pocket. Thank you. Looks like we got a little bit less money because we bought a car. Maybe not, I don't remember. We did buy a car though. It's actually a motorcycle. It's a Ducati. Ducati lookalike. Alright, so now we're going to roll straight from that guy, just about a block and a half, and we'll show you the map one more time. And there she blows. Right there. That's where we are. Right there. And look at that. We're already through 25. We made sure that you had plenty of time on that map there. Boy, you could have read a book in the amount of time we showed you that. My bad. All right, 25 finally accomplished. Now, 26 is out here on this peninsula on the northwestern bluff of it. So you can see it's way out there. We're going to hop on this boat, and we are actually going to mash around the way here. Well, don't mind our horrible driving. We may have been drinking and boating. I won't admit to anything, though. So we will just keep on keeping on here. And as you just follow the coastline along, heading south, you will eventually run into a patch of beach. And you guessed it, there is going to be a nice hidden lockbox there for us. Good news is you can kind of see it from a distance. So there it is right there. From a distance, baby. Now, I recommend, too, you don't come in super hot right here. You want to be able to re-drive the boat, or drive the boat out of there. I guess re-drive is kind of a silly way of saying that. So, anyways, now that we've got our mitts on this tasty lockbox out on the beach, with that realistic wave coming in and out there. Ooh, that's realistic. Yeah, look at that. All right, we're going to move on. We're going to actually just hop back in our boat. And go a little bit further down, and there's some aqueducts. Rumor is that there is a mission that takes you here at some point, but we weren't trying to wait for that mission. We were trying to knock out all 40 of North Point so that you guys could successfully do the same thing. Some of you may be a lot further than us as far as the story mode goes, so we want to try to get it all done. So you just keep heading south along the coastline. You can't miss it. Look at that. A big old entrance. You can drive your big old boat right in there. Look at that. A huge hole. Still managed to hit the wall. Leave it to me. And I will use the wall to help me turn, because I don't like slowing down, apparently. Unfortunately, I can't blame this driving on Corey. This was 100% me this time. But I will say that Corey does come in and ruin the video. That's right, Corey, if you're watching. No, he doesn't ruin the video. But he does shorten the display of my trophy that I earned for getting all 40 of these. You'll see. So, once you get into the aqueduct, you just pull in, get out, run over to the left-hand side. You can't miss it. It's flashing right in the corner. You do have to crack a safe, which cracking a safe can be fun, or it can be a pain in the ass. This one wasn't so bad, although it is taking me a little while. All right. Ooh, got a cleaver. Oh, no, that's just a knife. That ain't a cleaver. I look pretty excited about it, though, don't I? Woo! All right, so we're just going to hop right back in our boat and leave the aqueduct. Which, don't criticize my driving here either. Boats aren't so bad, but I'm just grateful there's no flying vehicles like in Lego Batman 2. Still embarrassed about my display of flying, especially on some of those like suit routes or minikit routes. Alright, so we are going to just head on the south shore and follow all the way. And as soon as we get to the shore here, you can't miss it. There's a couple guys, and you will fight them to the death. And once they're dead, you can take their lockbox that's shining right there. So make sure you pay attention to people trying to attack you, and you don't get kicked in the back. I'm pretty sure I get stomped again. Boom. Come on, man. I just want your lockbox. Just give up the lockbox. Oh, snap. Some of these moves are awesome. All right, kick him while he's down. Kick him while he's down. That's right. We're going to go ahead and grab that box. Booyaka shall. And we will not waste much more time and move on to 29. All right, so 29, we're going to just haul foot. That's right, haul foot. And basically, we're just going to kind of work our way down and inland a wee bit. We actually follow the pier all the way down. And then we bust a right, and it's not too far from here, I promise. Flashing lights. All right, so you're going to want to hijack a car. Obviously, there was no cars up there to hijack, so we'll grab this one that just seemed to be waiting for us to come and take it from him. And we actually had plans to go get one a little further off, but what was the sense of that when we drive right by this one? So, urge! You can see on our map, we had a different destination picked. However, it happens to be the next destination, so we won't let that go to waste. We'll go ahead and grab this one here. We're right alongside the highway, kind of in the southeastern corner of the entire map, really, but in specific of North Point. And after you fall asleep from boredom looking at that map, we'll hop out of the car, and we will go ahead and grab number 29. Yay! That one was easy. No guards, no picking the locks, no nada. Just give me that money. All right, number 30. Now we're going to go to our original destination, which is just about a block and a half up the street. We'll hop in our trusty truck carrying barrels. Looks like wine or something. Definitely not a keg. Unless people are making wooden kegs these days. Wouldn't surprise me. People are creative. Alright, we're just gonna keep on keeping on down the street. Alright, it's more than a block away. It's a little ways away. I was wrong. Whoops. We drive right by that. Nope, we don't know where we're going. Yes, we do. We always know where we're going. Although sometimes it may appear like we don't. We do. Alright, so we're going to make our way down across over there, and there you can see it inside that garage. Come on, put a little pep in your step, dude. People are waiting. Got things to do here. We got 10 more lockboxes to get. Sheesh. All right, so since we did make a nice little detour from where we started, we go ahead and show you the map one more time to show you the final point there. And then we will move on. All right, the top 10 countdown. Oh, look at that jump. You see that floater? Floating across the intersection. All right. That one's going to be an easy one to find as well. Hopefully we'll show you the map one more time. We're usually good about that. Oh, look at that. We're getting down onto the southernmost point of the island, and we'll go ahead and grab 31. Look at that cash stacking up there. 226,000. Okay, so we're going to start off right at 31, and we're going to hop this little fence. Who's that fence fooling? It ain't fooling us. We're going to run up to the top, and as you might have guessed it, there will be another lockbox all the way at the end of the pier in the back corner. In fact, you can see that flashing box from here. Dun, dun, dun. I like smashing boxes. I thought about making the jump there, but I didn't want to chance it and fall in the water. It looked silly. I do that on my own enough. Don't need to help myself. All right, so here we are. We are way out here on the corner. It's kind of a little pier. You can see in the southeast corner of the island. Doesn't get much more southeastern. And another 5K to add to our pile of cash. Won't be mad at that. All right, so here we are. Now we're basically at the south tip where the giant overpass is. Can't miss it. It's a giant circle. You're going to find your way under it. And you're going to run all the way around to the back of it. You'll find yourself a little group of thugs. Thuggity, thuggity, thuggity. There they blow. So we'll proceed to go ahead and smash some thug face in. Cha 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 cha. Yeah, that's right. Don't turn red on me. If you do, I'll just grab you and sweep you and kick you in the face. That's how it works. Alright, now, any guesses where that is, the lockbox? Ooh, good guess. Good guess. It's up on top. One quick peek at the map just to represent. As you can see there, it's just kind of on that bottom right side of the spiral. But remember, we are under it, not on it. So don't confuse yourself. And don't look at my blue destination there. It might be confusing. I think we show you the map one more time here as we kind of give you a look-see around to show you where everything is. Nah, just kidding. Oh, fooled you. So we're not too far from the cockfighting. Cockfights are right around the corner, which will bring us to our next lockbox, too. But let's go ahead and grab 33 first. Press the button already, dude. Come on. Triangle. Do it. Thank you. All right, and look at that. We got some J. Jiggler canvas. See, we're pimping. Now we got... I imagine that J. Jiggler is a variation of Dirk Diggler. Which is ironic because the other night when I was editing this, that movie happened to be on TV, and I hadn't quite made it to the lockboxes yet, so I hadn't seen the J. Jiggler. So I hadn't watched that movie in a long time, and I ended up watching it. But all right, so cockfights off to the left of the cockfights if you're looking at them head on. Can't miss it. Now here, we are way south. This is an island that I didn't even know existed, and it's just like a little oil refinery out in the middle of the ocean off the south, south, south pier. So... after we take a quick glance at nothing there, we will make our way up to the top of these crates. And we should take a nice little peek at the map here before we grab it, and we will show you. I wasn't kidding. We are way the hell out there. So there is a little oil refinery out there. It's a gambling den. You actually complete a favor out there to open the gambling den. And it's a real easy favor. You just throw some drunk dudes off the edge, two of them. Done deal. And we'll move back on to the island now. We're heading off to the west side of North Point, and we're going to head into the temple. We've been to the temple already for the health shrines and for also the two of the missions we've been on. So we're getting pretty familiar with this. So if you haven't already seen the lockbox all the way around the back, now's your chance to get it. But chances are you've probably already grabbed this lockbox along your journeys. I most certainly should have sped this up because I am boring myself right now. We will make our way directly around to the back and grab that lockbox, though. And with this lockbox, you actually get a knockoff Jay Jiggler jersey. So, probably not a very good street value, but you'll look cool to the ladies. You know what I'm saying? But not before you gotta hack this thing. So we'll go ahead and crack the safe. Ding, 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 ding. Come on, get those numbers. Slide to the right. Now move to the left. Stop. Think about it. Look at me. I'm struggling. Damn. I'm gonna take a quick nap while I figure this out. All right. 2 of 3. The world won't end before this video after all. All right. Look at that. We got it. Another safe cracked. All right. The home stretch. The final three. Or four, I guess, technically. So, 37. This one is up on top of the overpass. You can see we're up towards the top of it, but instead of being on top of it, we're going to follow around the corner, and we are going to pass that spy camera box. But, truth be told, we went and hacked it as soon as we got done with this little clip here. So, moving back inland a little bit and a little bit further north, we are going to go after these bad guys, which are also right by the overpass. And there are a couple dudes you gotta take out before you grab it, or I guess, you know, you probably could grab it on the run, but I always like to handle my business before I go in and take my cash. Yeah, that's right. It's my lockbox, punk. Boom. You know, he ain't gonna make sleeping dogs, too. Alright, so now that I give a nice glance around, make sure no one else wants any, I attempt to get my lockbox, and I can't. It hops me on the bike. So I will move the bike and grab the box. Boom. Gotta love it. Alright, last two. These ones are kind of crazy. There is a giant, I don't know if you want to call it a parkway or some sort of a scenic route. But you're going to want to follow that out there to the first little notch. Most of it's just road with no sides or anything, so it shouldn't be too hard to find. And once you get all the way out there, you will indeed find number 39. Now, 40 is just right up the way. We follow it. We keep following that road the way we were driving, and eventually we get to a crossroads, which allows us to come up to the top of the mountain. And once you get up there, you're going to want to run around back. The good news is that if you hoof it up there, you got a bike to mob out. So, all right. So our moment of truth. Our North Point scavenger trophy is about to pop. And Corey is about to come in and ruin it by logging off and his name displaying over the top of it. Bastard guy. All right. So this last one, you actually only get $2,100 for. That's kind of weak. You'd think you'd get a little bit more money for this one out in the middle of nowhere. But apparently the middle of nowhere isn't the best place to hide your large stacks of cash. So, we'll go ahead and grab it anyways. $2,100 to the bank. We are now over 2.5. Well, Booyakashow! North Point Scavenger. And there it is. V-Dub Nub is now offline. It should say V-Dub Nub has just ruined your video. Nah, I'm just playing. I always love giving Corey a bad time. Much love to Corey, though. He's a good guy. Regardless, that will end Sleeping Dogs Lockboxes North Point Video 2 of 2, where we show you all 40 of the North Point lockboxes and actually earn that North Point Scavenger Trophy. Feel free to comment, vote, subscribe if you like what we're doing. And, you know, if you're not on our Twitter, following us on Twitter, get on over there and follow us. We like to be followed. As always, until next time. See ya.